Hello, class. It's Professor Nelson again. It's the Jewelry Design Department at the Fashion Institute of Technology. Continuing our demo tutorial on technical studies, sketching for technical drawing. Picking up where I left off, we've done our flattened top view, we've done our flattened front view, and now I'm going to wrap it on the round. Bring up my grid. Going to That might be a little too loose. Okay. Unfortunately, the grid is not lined up, so I'm going to take a minute here and reorient some of the drawing elements. Okay. Very good. So, ready to start carrying information around. I can bring down a line directly. In fact, I'll go ahead and do that. I can bring down a guideline, and that will allow me to establish the width of my bezel. I need to establish the height from this elevation, so from here to here. It's going to be somewhere about there. Now, I have to kind of compromise because the elevation is higher at the sides because the ring bore lower in the middle. So I kind of pick something in between. If I bring it straight down, it's going to be kind of metallic and heavy looking. If I bring it straight into the center of the circle, it'll be too sharp. So I'm going to do a compromise there. Looking up, it's clear that the entire front of the false bezel covers or occludes the shank. So I'll go ahead and remove the shank. Okay. It's also obvious that the elevation here is thicker than what I have here. So I'll go ahead and do a little bit thicker. While I'm at it, I'll go ahead and indicate roughly those distances. It's going to be a little narrower on the bottom because of the curvature. It's going to be a little wider on the top. And these will radiate more or less into the center. And then one more, which is actually kind of a half piece. Something like that. Take a minute and clean up my drawing a little bit. Imagine you hear the dab, dab, dab of a kneaded eraser. Okay. These should be fairly similar to the same distance, these two cells. So I'll clean up my lines to make that more the case than not. Here the shank comes in and eats up almost all of this. Something like that. Okay. And now I'm going to bring in these partitions. This is quite close in. Here it's roughly equidistant. And here it should be roughly equidistant. Okay. What I'm seeing as I do this is that these boxes are looking a lot smaller than that box. So, I'll fix it. That's the beauty of it being a study. We are not committed to anything yet. Okay, something along in there. Even a little longer still. Now I have my line that goes all the way up to the top elevation, and the line indicating the other side. And now I draw the next piece. Something like that. Might be a little bit short. I think that's good, and make sure it still traces pretty much to the center. Then I have my next vertical line climbing up to the upper elevation. Something like that. And then this rides about a half a length of one of these. Out and beyond. That last puff. Gonna let these all round a little bit now. Something like that. Going to now draw the pyramids. Okay. Now I'm going to draw the stone. Oh, hang on. There. I want it to be just about this distance, which is close to that grid line. Quite close to it, but not exact. A little bit below. And then the table, which is a little bit higher than that distance was. Something like that. Take my guideline. That'll give me that line for the pavilion. That'll give me a line for the crown. Clean it up. And then bring in my prongs, which I can do by eye. Come straight up from the side of the false bezel. Be careful about zooming in. You start to see things you want to fix that at scale you don't really need to fix. Yeah, see, I fall to it too. I fall for that same thing. I want to overwork my drawings. Okay, and that will complete we go. Okay. That's done. Thanks for watching.